Hi guys, back with putting it straight. Oh my god, I hate this camera. Okay. Back with part 5. I kind of messed up on some stuff. So I kind of have to fix what I did here. I'm sorry for being away. Try not to be in my camera. Point. Okay. Anyways, so we're starting back over. You're just gonna see a little repeat of old footage. Not old footage, but old gameplay from. Just like as if it was the previous part. So, just try and get some of these, I can't move. Get out of here. Sweepy level up 9. Good. Come on, Sweepy. More freaking dream eaters. I just really want to move forward already and oh god dang it. Oh of course it's cats again. I swear the cats in this game are like the most annoying dream eaters. I love more of ones like Sweetie because I honestly want to get another Sweetie spirit I think, but at the same time. I just like having Sweet Pea in my spirit. That just gives me more time. Come on, Sweet Pea. Move on forward. I think we're in another spot now of importance. Oh, we're back in the town hall? Oh, great. What I don't get is, though, why Riku and Sora still haven't met up again. I guess it's just because, like the guy said in Traverse Town, I think is what it was, that it's, they're in parallel worlds. I just gotta find out. Oh my god, I saw another one. There it is. our next spot of interest, I think.
Oh.
Yeah, I haven't been here yet. Oh, finally, a save point. All right, then this is perfect. The challenge, which sucks, but don't drop him in the middle of the battle. Don't you dare. Don't you dare. Don't do it. It's gonna drop. Alright, so you can just stay right here. I don't get it.
I just don't get it. Want the attacks because they're all freaking rhinos. Bleh.
Oh well. Jesus,
not again. No, I
I should really try.
Oh, you're different. You're different. Oh, a completed one, finally. That's at least a plus.
Please tell me I'm heading in the right direction. Please tell me I'm heading in the right direction. Outskirts. They're just gonna loop. Oh, I didn't want to come that way. I want to go the other way. Oh, I just flipped around. Okay, now I'm going the right direction. What? Oh, hello. No, 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 no.
I was short from one. Yeah, I know. I'm short of one. Hey, Kevin, you level up again. Point. You bet your rear end I'm saving. I should always save some stuff for now. I should buy stuff. all right?
Quasimodo, where did the creature go?
It's up there.
Right.
Wait. Wait, I'll go with you.
Thanks, but stay with her. Quasimodo, did your heart have the answer?
I need her. No, let me move! No. Any potion again. Okay, one more. Okay. Time for a comp.
Master Frollo, he made me live inside the bell tower. But the real walls were the ones I built around my heart. You helped me see that, Rico.
I was speaking from personal experience.
I'd say you still keep a lot locked inside.
We all do that sometimes. There are just some things we need to keep separate from the world at large. At least until we have time to figure them out.
I know the road my heart walks.
Yep, new world time. Oh, cool. Guardian belt. Keyblade. Nice. Thank you.
easiest drop I've ever had to do. Yay, silver diver again. I wonder how you can get A. Am I in a world of Tron?
My clothes. Is this world special? A dream here. No. Let's see how this plays out.
Oh my god, I'm in the world of Tron.
Another stray.
Oh, that means I have to defeat that stupid monster, get a Sora. Man. Oh well. I think I'm in the world of Tron.
Are you a prisoner?
Yep, World of Tron.
Yeah, it looks that way. Name's Sam. I'm Riku. Where are we, Sam?
We're on the grid.
Only a precious few are granted life cycle battle privileges.
You gonna explain why it's so lucky?
I'll show you.
How hard can it be?
Kidding me? A dream eater in this place? Ah, jeez.
Oh, it's a boss level again? Pretty cool. And I love how they got the remaster of the graphics for this game. What was that? They're almost down for saving. That's a plus. Hey! There we go. Wasn't so bad.
From the games.
Yeah.
I know a way off the grid. Wanna come with?
No. You go ahead. Wait, what's the way out?
Through the portal.
Portal?
Yeah. It's like a gate that opened when I came here. Once I'm back in the real world, I can delete Clue. And then my dad will be able to come home.
Your dad?
He vanished 20 years ago when he came here to the grid. But because he needed to protect his disc from Clue, he went into hiding. He's been trapped there ever since. But I'm gonna change.
I gotta do a rescue somebody.
I see. Sam, you mind if I go with you after all? To the portal?
Sure. I'll take what help I can get. But first, there's somebody I need to meet. He's in the city.
Buttons next to the codes. Great. Great. More new stuff.
I tried to get back, but I couldn't get to the portal. It uses massive power and it can't stay open forever. And like a safe, it can only be open from the outside. It closed on me, Sam. That's why I never came home.
So the portal, it activated when I came in. So it's open now.
Not for long. Only one millicycle. About 8 hours.
So we go now. We go home. We make a run for it. We get you
Sam,
out of here.
Don't rush.
What do you mean, don't rush? The portal's gonna close.
My disc is everything, Sam. It's the master key. The golden ticket, the way out, and not just for me.
What do you mean?
Our worlds are more connected than anyone knows. Clue figures if I can be him,
he can be out.
With my disc, it's possible.
And then what?
Game over. The guy doesn't dig in perfection. It's more imperfect than our world. I can't let that happen. I won't.
So what do we do? Nothing?
It's amazing how productive doing nothing can be. Clue is planning something. We've known that for a while. It's his game now. The only way to win is not to play.
Yeah, well, that's a hell of a way to live.
But it is a way. Sometimes life has a way of moving you past things like wants and hopes.
That's great, Dad. Keep telling yourself that.
Good night, Sam.
There's a safe spot soon. That's great. What's it? Two spots. Something's gonna happen, I think. Oh, now. Whoa, whoa, whoa. You shoot stuff from. That's so weird. Hey, whoa, 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 whoa.
thing.
This.
I'm Riku. Sam and I were on our way to the portal.
Come with us.
Where are we headed?
The portal. But we need a solar sailor. There's one in the underground docks.
The stolen disc. Let's see how this goes.
She's stable.
We have to go back. Clue would use it to reach the outside world. I can stop him from destroying it if you just let me do this.
You've done enough already.
So what do we do now?
I don't know. Nothing. We do nothing. Be still. Wait. Hop a solar sailor. A full-on sprint to the portal. We can beat Clue there. Let's get her out of here.
Can I
place is... Oh, wait. I can't forget you. All right, now we can go to the next place. Come on, Kevin. Another new place. Here we go. Oh, I'm going to be dropping soon. Drop me in the middle of the ball. I'm just like, don't you dare even try. No. It's gonna drop me in the middle of the fight, isn't it? Yep. Well. Onward, back. Well, I gotta go back. Oh, hello. So I came from there, I'm going to another one? Or am I just going in another circle? Because I'm like, this just seems so weird. Why am I going? Oh, I can't forget that. I see you. Drop me not. Alright, let's go. Down to another hole. Let me guess, another... Find this secret passage you keep moving on. More trap gas. Okay.
awesome. Yeah. So cute. Yeah. She's killing it. Nope. And yes, there we go. Did you find a pass to play? Yes, you did. Good girl. Oh, hey, another big chest. Yes. Now, I really hope there's a save point soon because I want to save. I hate it when there's no save points for long periods of time. Oh no. It's that. Yes, that makes me drop quicker. I don't like that.
Quasimodo? What are you doing here?
Phoebus and I came to warn you. Frollo's on his way.
Take what you can and flee.
Well done, Gandalf. Thankfully, you are every bit as predictable as I had thought. Here, Quasimodo. I always knew you would someday be of use to me. I have you at last, you witch.
She isn't a witch, though, you jerk.
There'll be a bonfire in your square.
No. Please, Master.
Understands that he means burning her at the stake, because at that time she was considered a witch just because she didn't believe in religion. Another boss battle. Last time you were flying, now you're not flying.
I should have known you'd risk your life to save that gypsy witch. Just as your own mother died in her pitiful attempt to save you.
What?
Now, I'm going to do what I should have done 20 years ago.
Forever!
Quasimodo, you can't let your heart beat.
I know. I can't blame Frollo for putting walls around me. It wasn't the walls that were holding me back. But my heart is free now. I'm ready to really see what's out there.
Did I complete it? No. Yes? No. Maybe.
All that time, Quasimodo let himself be trapped inside the nightmares Frollo gave him.
Hypocrite. You are the one who has made your heart a prison.
You again? What are you talking about?
Even if you are not the prisoner.
What? Heartless Sora? Huh? That's right, because Sora lost his heart. At least I think he did. At least Sora now can get out of this world and into the next, finally.
My heart? A prison?
By sleep, Master Xehanort decided to abandon his people Ventus on Destiny Islands. The boy's heart was fractured, useless, but his heart was saved when a new heart found Ventus and helped him fill the void. Several years passed, and Ventus forgot what had happened. He had found a new home in the Land of Departure, a sacred ground defended by a longtime Keyblade Masters. There, he met two other youths named Aqua and Terra, and together they trained Master Araquas to become Keyblade Masters. Both Aqua and Terra should have been named Keyblade Masters. Master Xehanort intervened, convincing Araquas to test his pupils with a mark of mastery examination. While Aqua passed the test, Terra did not, creating a rift between him and his friends. Shortly after, the tidings of unversed strange creatures that thrived on negativity, and Master Xehanort broke off all communication. Terra left to solve both mysteries. Ventus ran away to be with his friend. As for Aqua, Araquas tasked her with keeping Terra under surveillance and bringing Ventus home as soon as possible. Thus, their journeys began. During Terra's travels, Master Xehanort whittled away at the young man's ethics, convincing him that darkness and light were equally important and that a balance must be kept. Elsewhere, Ventus met Mickey, another trainee, and found himself crossing keyblades with a mysterious masked boy named Vanius. The three friends were reunited in Radiant Garden, but too much had changed. Terra felt betrayed by Araquas and Aqua and retreated deeper into Xehanort's clutches. Ventus sided with Terra and ran off again, and Aqua was left to deal with a mixture of guilt, concern, and love. Guided by fate, perhaps, Terra arrived at the Destiny Islands and met Riku. He decided to bequeath the power of a Keyblade to this little boy who reminded him so much of himself. And sometime after, Aqua visited these islands and discovered what Terra had done. She too found a kindred spirit in Riku's friend Sora and told the boy to stick by his friend and guide him even for the darkest of times. Ventus had made a discovery of his own. While rescuing Mickey, he was confronted by Master Xehanort and learned of his connection to a weapon called the X-Blade. Ventus returned to Master Araquas in search of answers about his past, but a truthful disaster was waiting to happen, and Master Araquas had no choice to lock his people's heart away to keep that disaster contained. Terra arrived just in the nick of time and battled his master to protect his friend, but this was exactly what Master Xehanort hoped for. Terra watched in horror as his new mentor struck the weakened Araquas down. He'd been fooled. Terra tried to move Ventus someplace safe in the Destiny Islands, but Ventus, the boy with the mask, was already there. Join with me. Become the X-Blade. And then Ventus remembered the truth. Vanius was a part of him, the darkness which had been extracted from his heart. Led by Destiny, Terra and Ventus and Aqua assembled in the Keyblade graveyard. In the distance, Master Xehanort and Vanius appeared. A violent clash ensued, and at the time of it, Terra's body was possessed by Xehanort. Meanwhile, Ventus had been forced into a clash of his counterpart Vanius chose the destruction of them both to prevent the X-Blade from being forged. In the aftermath, Mickey was able to rescue Aqua, and Ventus would not wake, and Terra was nowhere to be found. Aqua's journey was not over. Aqua recalled her master's teachings. After finding a safe place,
her Venice to rest, she walked the land with departure, which would eventually come to be known as Castle Oblivion. Ventisar is nearly snuffed out, so he retreated to the safety of Sora's heart, the same new heart that had saved him once before. Aquafina confronted Xehanort, who possessed Terra's body. After a long fight, Aqua dove into the darkness and sacrificed herself to usher Terra back to a realm of light. Aqua wandered the realm of darkness. Aqua dove into the realm of darkness and sacrificed herself to usher Terra back to a realm of light. Aqua wandered the realm of darkness for a decade before meeting a stranger there. This stranger told her about a certain boy who had become the savior of all worlds. When Aqua heard the boy's name, tears filled her eyes and her face beamed with hope. And that hero, you'll find out later. Or maybe you may already know.
Hey, Axel, you haven't forgotten.
Oh my god.
Well,
yes.
You made us a promise. I do. That you'd always be there. To bring us back. Yeah.
Axel. He's like one of my favorites.
I'm not.
And Roxas!
Best friends forever. Only the ones who joined the organization here. I guess Xehanort doesn't count. But where are Brake and Isa?
Fifty days? Oh my gosh. Should I read this? I better just read this. When Roxas first became part of the organization, he spent his days on missions collecting hearts and befriending another member named Axel. However, when Axel was sent to Castle Oblivion on a special mission, Roxas teamed up with the organization's new 14th member, a girl named Shion. Slowly, the two warmed to each other. Once Axel returned from his mission, he, Roxas, and Shion, developed a routine of ending each busy day by having an ice cream atop the Twilight Town clock tower. There he talked about work, friendship, and the memories and the meaning of the heart. One day, Xion was ordered to dispatch an imposter, Riku, who had donned the organization's robes to protect Sora. But Xion was overpowered and told her Keyblade was a sham. After failing a second mission, she slipped into a coma. When Xion finally awaked, Roxas' daily routine resumed a kind of normalcy, but something in his friend had changed. Slowly, Xion began to question her own existence. On day 255, Xion visited Castle Oblivion and discovered what she was. Roxas waited for Xion at the tower, but she never came. The next day, he learned that she deserted the organization. Roxas tracked her down and tried to convince her to return, but Xion drew her keyblade threateningly. It was once Axel appeared that he and Roxas were able to bring her back by force. After learning some of the truth about Xion, Roxas found his own existence thrown into question. He had lost faith in Axel and the organization, who kept so much hidden from him, and decided to run away. Meanwhile, Shion tracked a girl down named Naminé and decided to return her share of Sora's memories to their owner. Axel hunted her down and made a double-edged promise. Keep running. I'll always be there to bring you back. After barely managing to keep that promise, Axel collapsed, and Zenmus, the organization's leader, took Shion away. Aimlessly, Roxas found himself wandering towards the clock tower. There, Shion revealed herself not to be a her at all, but a faceless puppet that the organization had created as a cage for Sora's memories. The last of those memories were inside Roxas, Sora's nobody, and she would have to take them from him to become a complete Sora replica. The two fought, and Shion got her wish. She was defeated. As the memories that made her up returned to Sora, she ceased to exist and vanished in the minds of all who knew her. Confused and angry, Roxas decided to challenge Zenmus and the organization. Free from the hearts they collected and destroy Kingdom Hearts, but Roxas was not strong enough to win, and as he fell there, Sora would never awaken and Riku comfort him. In his mind, Riku heard the last wish of a girl whose name he could no longer remember, to stop Roxas. He nearly failed until it allowed the darkness in his heart to take over before he was able to subdue Roxas. A boy named Roxas woke up in his room in Twilight Town after having another strange dream. Excited, he ran off to meet his friends at their usual spot. Only 7 days of summer vacation left. Ooh, that's rough, buddy. I'm going in the world. Damn, still recording. And hopefully if I can stay here soon, because I think I have to get ready for work soon. Defeat Brawlamari. And Tron was good. Making the grid. I just gotta figure out where the next save spot is because I wanna save. I need to save. Oh, thank God. Right here. I am saving right now. Alright, everybody. Thanks for watching, as always. We'll continue on in the next one. Alright, Medical Gamer out. Peace out, guys.